Welcome to Synchronous Motor Video Part 2. Today we will be seeing the principle of operation of synchronous motor. Let us see. The parts first. Synchronous motor, it is similar to synchronous generator. What is synchronous generator? Synchronous generator is alternator. Synchronous motor is having similar parts to that of synchronous generator or alternator. Okay, so the parts are stator, rotor and exciter. Same for both synchronous motor and alternator. So theoretically we can say a synchronous generator or alternator can be working as a synchronous motor. Now the supplies. Generally the rotor will be having the field. It is not mandatory, but still it is almost used as the rotor. The rotor will be having DC supply. Rotor is the field of synchronous motor. Okay, and the stator. Stator will be given AC supply. Generally, three-phase AC supplies are used. So, the stator is having armature and it is given by AC supply, that is around 415 volt for small motors. And when AC is given to motors, we know what alternating magnetic field or revolving magnetic field is set up. You can see RYB, the colors are shown by vector diagrams. So at different instants, it will be having different magnitudes. Okay. When yellow is increasing, the other things are reducing and you can see RYB variation. But the black one is the common one. That is the effective magnetic flux. Resultant magnetic field, it will be like this and it will be same all the time. And resultant magnetic flux is rotating. And this is the magnetic field rotation, we can say. Now, you can see the same thing here. The revolving magnetic field when three-phase supply is given. So, it is a rotating magnetic field. Now, we are not showing any rotor in this item. So, synchronous motor, stator, it is having rotating or revolving magnetic field. Okay, now let us see the working. The three-phase AC supply is given and it will be setting up a revolving flux. And what happens to the rotor? Rotor is supplied by DC. DC supply is there. So what happens to rotor? Rotor is becoming a magnet. Okay. So this is a magnet. And at a particular instant, what is happening? You can see there is a N pole here, S pole here in the stator. For simplicity, we are considering two pole synchronous motor stator. And we know it is a AC supply to the stator and this N and S will be continuously getting changed. Okay. Now, what happens to the polarity here? The N and N are together or near. So, it cannot be like that. The similar poles will ripple. Is it not? So, it has to move out. In this way, it will be trying to move because of the similar pole repulsion. In next movement, what will happen? You can see the polarity of the stator has changed. N came to S and S changed to N. Okay. So, previously N was coming here, but the stator polarity has changed. Now, what happens? The N has to come back to this side. So, previously it was in this direction, but after some time, it has to go this direction, reverse. So, ab dekha hoga. When you are, you may be seen the cat. If you are putting something in front of that, it will be moving its head continuously. Effectively, average we can say it is becoming a stationary thing. Okay, so like this, the rotating magnetic field will be rotating and the rotor. What happens? Rotor will be stationary. Okay. So, the rotor is stationary. under normal conditions for the synchronous motor. In another words, we can say the synchronous motor is not self-starting. The synchronous motor will stand still when supply is given like this. So it will not start directly. It is not self-starting. Now, we are seeing a synchronous motor in the working condition now. Rotor is rotating. What happens? It is rotating in the same speed. So the revolving flux will be having a speed, and this rotor also is rotating at the same speed. Okay, that is synchronous speed. You can see it is rotating at the synchronous speed. How can this be made? That is a question. Okay, so one thing, it is moving, that is revolving flux is moving, the rotor, it is stationary. Now, if we want to rotate in the same speed, if we want to catch up the speed, what you will be able to do? Okay, you can see a moving bus is there. Okay, if you want to get into that bus, we have to run behind the bus. We also should be moving with the speed of the bus. When your speed and the speed of the bus is same, you can get into the bus. Is it? So for the synchronous motor also same thing happens. Some prime mover has to be, some movement has to be given so that the rotor has to be rotated almost near to the synchronous speed. Okay, so that is the idea. So the synchronous motor can be made rotating by making its rotor rotating near to the synchronous speed. Okay, so that we will be discussing detailedly, the methods of starting synchronous motor. So when the synchronous motor will rotate at synchronous speed, when the revolving flux speed it is available, if the rotor is also rotating in the same speed, this synchronous motor will be rotating at synchronous speed continuously. Why? That will be told now. Okay, if this rotor is not rotating, it will be not rotating. So the synchronous motor will be having only two conditions. It can rotate at synchronous speed or it will not rotate. Okay, so to run at synchronous speed, what should be done? The polarity S and N should be moving in synchronous speed only. Otherwise, the rotor will stop. Okay, so that is the idea. So the methods of starting will be detailedly telling how the motor can be started. Okay, not that all. This is the way finally a synchronous motor will be working. You can see the stator flux is rotating, and in the same condition, rotor also will be rotating at synchronous speed. Okay, so by the starting methods, we'll be telling how it is happening. Now we are considering the motor has only a round shape like this, but it can be linear also. Okay, so like this, it is made a linear synchronous motor. Linear synchronous motor, you can say the windings are available in the bottom side, the windings are available here, and we need a magnetic item here, permanent magnet. We can give permanent magnet. What happens when the field is moving? Okay, whenever alternating supply is given, the field will the armature will be changing the flux and it will be keep on moving, and this is a permanent magnet. What happens? The magnet and this AC supply will be synchronized together, and this item will be keep on moving. Okay, so this will be known as what? Linear synchronous motor. Okay, linear induction motor also is there. This is known as linear synchronous motor. Practically it is happening like this. You will be able to see moving magnets here, and coil it has been given here. Okay, so the coil will be given AC supply. It will be having varying flux and varying magnetism. So with respect to magnetism, what happens? Moving magnet also moves. So this can be used in this sort of conveyor applications. Okay, so we are going to see the methods of starting synchronous motor in our next class. Okay.